उनका काम है कि खोलना मतलब फिर कि बाकी कोई भी नहीं होता वो
أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري وهل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ تعالی وبرکاتہ Dear brothers and sister, my name is Sayyid Zuhair Akhtar and I am one of the Minhaj youth league coordinators here. Through the numerous bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, blessings of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam, and through the faiz of Huzur Shaykhul Islam Dr. Muhammad Tahirul Qadri, we have this opportunity today to gather here collectively to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam during this blessed night of Mawlidun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. On behalf of Minhaj al-Quran Dallas, I welcome all of you to this special program. I would also like to welcome a well-known poet and nasheed reciter as our special chief guest, Brother Sayyid Sabiuddin Rahmani among us, who came for this special evening all the way from Pakistan.
That's what it should be.
I would like to mention the format of tonight's program for your convenience. We have two MCs for tonight, myself and Brother Mubin Miang. The program will commence with Qirat, translation of Qirat, Nasheed performances, brief speeches on the significance of Mawlidun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by our esteemed scholars, Dr. Zafar Anjum Sahab, Dr. Ziaul Haq Sahab, and Sheikh Asil Khan Sahab, and then beautiful dance, inshallah, from our chief guest, Sayyid Sabiuddin Rahmani Sahab. The program will end, inshallah, with salam and dua. So before I start the program, I would like to invite our chief nasheed reciter, Sayyid Sabiuddin Rahmani, and our esteemed scholars to come up on the stage, please. Abu Umama radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrated that Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, "Recite the Quran, for the day of resurrection it will come on as an intercessor for those who recite it." Reported in Sahih Muslim. So with that hadith, I would like to invite Brother Hafiz Samir Bhura, who is completing his hifz with Sheikh Asil Khan Sahab and is in 10th grade in high school and learning Qirat is his passion, mashallah. The verses from the Quran that is going to be recited are Surah Duha with the translation. So over to you, sir.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والضحى ولا الآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى بسم الله ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث صدق الله العلي العظيم
And now for the translation inshallah أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم By the growing morning bright, when the sun gains height and spreads its radiance, or by the growing sunshine of your messengership rising like the morning bright, whose radiance has replaced the darkness of ignorance with the enlightenment of guidance. And by the night when it covers up, ever since he has chosen you, your Lord has not forsaken you, nor is he displeased ever since he has taken you as his beloved. SubhanAllah. following hour is a better source of eminence and exaltation for you than the preceding one. And soon your Lord shall bestow upon you so much that you will be well pleased. O beloved, did he not find you an orphan and then provided you a dignifying and graceful abode? Or did he not find you compassionate and provided in your person a shelter for orphans? And he found you engrossed and loved and lost in his love, and then made you achieve the coveted objective. And he found you a leader for a straying people, so he provided them guidance through you. Subhanallah. And he found you seeking closeness with your Lord, and then blessed you with the pleasure of his sight and freed you of every need forever. And he found you compassionate and benevolent, and then through you made the destitute non-liable. So never should you be strict with any orphan, nor reproach any beggar seeking help at your door, and proclaim well the bounties of your Lord. Jazakallahu khairan.
Brother Hafiz Samir, for that beautiful recitation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the listening of Quran recitation as a source of light for all of us. Ameen. Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, teach your children three things. Love of your Prophet, love of his Prophet's family, that is Ahl Bayt, and to recite the Quran. Reported by Imam Dalami. Next, I will be inviting Sunday school students of Minhajul Quran to come up on the stage to recite Qasida Burda Sharif to express their love for our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. MashaAllah, these students are learning Qasida and Nasheed as a part of the curriculum of Sunday Islamic School here.
Mawlaya Salih.
Ameen. Shaykh al-Islam, Dr. Muhammad Taher Qadri, has greeted the Muslims around the globe on the advent of the holy month of Rabiul Awwal. In his message on this occasion, Shaykh al-Islam said that the onset of the blessed month brings with it a message of peace, happiness, and tranquility. He said that our individual happiness was no match to the collective happiness symbolized by this blessed month. Truly, my brothers and sisters, we are fortunate that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the opportunity tonight to commemorate the blessed birth of His beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. So moving on with our program inshallah, next, I would like to invite Brother Imtiaz Jan to please come up on the podium to recite the naat in the praise of our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam.
غياب جوز تجوز
Citing such a heart-touching nasheed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase you in your melodies. Ameen. One of the names of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Mahmud. This name means the one who is praised. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was attributed with this name as his noble qualities are praised in abundance. So moving forward with the program inshallah. Next, I will invite the sisters, the alumni of Sunday School Minhajul Quran, to recite a nasheed in the praise of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And inshallah, after the nasheed, Brother Mubin will be the MC for the next half of the program. So I'll hand over to the sisters.
Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa barik wa sallim. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammadin. Huzur aapko aaye to dil jagmagaye. Huzur aapko aaye to dil jagmagaye. Marna na chaaron ka kya haal hota. Asiron kameezon guzarti asiron kameezon pe kya kuch guzarti musibat ke maron ka kya haal hota huzur aap aaye to dil jagmagaye
Next, I would like to invite Brother Iqbal Hassan on the stage for some announcements.
MashaAllah, I'm so glad to see you everybody here today. It is with the God's blessing that we are all here today listening to a great program in celebration of Miladun Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I would like to let you know about the services that we offer at Minhajul Quran Jamia Hasan al-Basri. MashaAllah, we have Quran evening classes for all ages, Monday to Thursday from 4 to 8 p.m. Those classes are conducted by Imam Dr. Zia. Also, every Tuesday, we have Tafsir Quran program as well. This program is conducted after Salatul Isha. The program is led by Imam Dr. Zafar Anjum. Also, we are starting a new program coming this Wednesday. This will be about Quranic Arabic, where we will all learn the meaning and the message of the Quran. This program will be conducted by Imam Dr. Zia. MashaAllah, these all scholars are here that are normally presiding and conducting these programs here at Minhajul Quran. All of these programs are conducted after Salatul Isha. These days, Salatul Isha is at 8 p.m. And inshallah, throughout the month, throughout this winter season, it's going to be at 8 o'clock too. As you just saw some of the students from Sunday Islamic School, I'm very proud to let you know that we have third year of Sunday Islamic School running here. And it is with the God's blessing. Every year, we have more students enrolled than we targeted. So we, mashallah, there is something good about the school that we have many students keep coming and bringing other students as well. The curriculum of the school was, or these classes were designed especially for these students with this in mind that they are in America and living with the multicultural and multi-faith society as well. So whatever we wanted our kids to learn and whatever we missed them teaching them and whatever we didn't get to learn, we made sure that is part of the curriculum. And you will also notice that today they were here doing the nasheed as well. MashaAllah, they are learning these things and one day we hope they will be coming standing here and doing the nasheed too, inshallah. Also, every other Saturday, we have Darse Quran for sisters only. This is after Salatul Dhuhr, from 2:30 to 3:30, 1 hour, every other Saturday. Minhajul Quran Youth League, or Minhaj Youth League, is pretty active here at Minhaj. They have several programs conducted. They have collected money for Rohingya Muslims. They have collected money for Gaza, Syria as well in the past. Inshallah, coming on December 10th, we will have a program for them after Salat al-Dhuhr at 2:30. This is for all brothers and sisters, youth, as well as for the family as well. This is the way that we are designing, that we want the parents to be a part of this program as well. So this is going to be Sunday, December 10th, and this will be led by Imam Dr. Zia. We have several books at the back over there. They are books written by, authored by Dr. Muhammad Tahir al-Qadri. As you would see, if you get the chance to go down into our lobby, you will see there are many, many books that are all authored by Sheikh al-Islam. We have those books available for purchase. If you would like to buy that, please do so. We also have many items at the back that are available for sale. If you would like to purchase those, all proceeds will go to Minhajul Quran Dallas. Also, if you would like to join our WhatsApp group or our email distribution list, we have a sign-up sheet at the back. You can sign up and you will inshallah come to know all the offerings that we have here at Minhajul Quran. As many of you may know, that at Minhaj we celebrate all 12 days of Milad. MashaAllah, that culminated yesterday. We completed 12 days of Milad al-Nabi here. And every night we had a nasheed, and mashallah, many local nasheed reciters were here, and many of our scholars were here too for the bayan each night. One of the brother offered for our youth to encourage them, and he said that if any of the students will come here, or any youth will come here for all 12 nights, he or she will be rewarded. MashaAllah, there are four youngsters that they qualify for that. As I call up their name, I would like them to please come forward. These are, starting from the youngest, Ishan Mushtaq. Ishan, would you please come forward? Thank you so much for coming here every day. MashaAllah, SubhanAllah. At this time, I would like everybody to say MashaAllah and SubhanAllah. We need to encourage our youngsters. Adil Marfani. Adil. While we are waiting for Adil, Simra Marfani, mashallah. And Aisha Mushtaq, mashallah. These are also our Sunday school students as well. We continue to encourage our students to come forward and participate in every program that we offer here. Many of these students, these girls, they do participate in our Halqa program every Friday that which we offer. And is that in that Halqa program, there's always a scholar present as well. And also we have a deed recited by one of these students too. So we are trying to encourage as many youngsters to come forward and get over any strange fright they may have, as well as they learn from what they are being taught here as well. Towards the end, when we exit, inshallah, I'll come as well and try to give you some housekeeping rules at the end. But at this time, thank you very much for listening to me, and I will invite Brother Mubin Mia to continue with the second half of our segment. Jazakallah khair.
ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته ما شاء الله I'd like to thank all the kids who came all the way to the adults every one of you who showed up and especially our special guest Imam Zafar Anjum Saab, Imam Sheikh Asil Khan Saab, and Imam Zia, and especially our special guest, Sabiuddin Rahmani. So I would like to give a warm welcome to all of you who came. Inshallah, I would like to start off the program with something that Imam Shafi narrates. Imam Shafi writes that the heart with no love and the heart with no pain for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that heart is a heart of not ever mu'min. Now, what is a mu'min? A mu'min has just one mission. And that mission is to gain the love, to gain the ishq for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So alhamdulillah, all you guys are here today, and all you guys, Allah have given you the tawfiq to gain the love and to gain the ishq of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam by coming to this program, inshallah. So with that, once we take a look at the level of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there's so much our psychological mind can take. There's so much we can perceive, because Allah has blessed Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam with something we can't ever imagine. So with that, our respected son of Huzur Sayyidu Shaykh al-Islam, Dr. Muhammad Tahir al-Qadri, Dr. Hussein Qadri, narrates and says, today the Muslim Ummah is celebrating the prophetic arrival, which is a spiritual extension of the past. So this blessed commemoration of the prophetic birth of Huzur Pak sallallahu alaihi wasallam will continue till the very, very end. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the tawfiq and the guidance to keep on gaining the ishq, to keep on gaining the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and also help spreading it to others, inshallah. So with that being said, I would now like to invite my father, Dr. Mansoor, to come up for an intro of our special guest, Sabiuddin Rahmani.
warahmatullahi wabarakatuhu. It's a very big honor for us and for this organization, especially Minhaj al-Quran International, that all around the globe we have been celebrating Maulud al-Nabi on regular basis through the blessing of Hazur Shaykh al-Islam Dr. Muhammad Tahir al-Qadri. And through his guidance, we were successfully able to complete 12 days of Maulud al-Nabi at Jamia Hassan al-Masri this year as well. And we are blessed, and all those families who participated, the children especially who came in on regular basis. I'm very grateful to all of them, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and give them a long life to continue with those programs. So when I came to know that this year Sabiuddin Rahmani Saab has been coming in, I was very delighted to meet him last year, and I decided to invite him again because I found him last year, he was a little different from others. The little difference has the biggest meaning in it. If you see the little difference from others, it's a magnificent difference. Through that little difference, he is outstanding and distinguished from others. So why he is outstanding and distinguished from others? Let me tell you through a few words. So he is not only a renowned Naat reciter, he is also a Naat researcher. So he is a poet, and he has done the research work in Naat that has been recognized all around the globe. And through his research work, he has written multiple books. So you can see the lot of books up there displayed for written by Hazur Shaykh al-Islam Dr. Muhammad Tahir al-Qadri, but there is also one table up there and a few books that I have brought here. One is the Naat Rang, all right, and the other one is the reverence into his feet, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is a very, very nice volume, all right. And Fida'i Rahmat, Zaida'i Rahmat, yes, it's a Zaida'i Rahmat. So there are multiple other books, and if you would like to stop by, please take it. And it's a very rare to find those kind of books up here. So Sayyid Sabihuddin Rahmani Saab definitely has blessed with multiple awards. He was awarded by Radio Pakistan Karachi in 1995. There was the performance, Best Performance Award. He also had a President Award for Naat Rang through the Ministry of Religious Affairs, Government of Pakistan in 2004. Europark Award by Europark Austria. And he also has a Creative Poet Award from the House of Commons from Canada. So he has written multiple books up here, and inshallah you will enjoy listening him. And if you get a chance, go into his website, just search Sayyid Sabihuddin Rahmani, and you will get a lot of other credentials. Because of the short of time, I'll not be able to go into the details of it. So I would request Brother Sabihuddin Rahmani to come up at the podium and to lead the next of the program. Thank you.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته ایک بار پھر منہاج القرآن ڈالس کے پلیٹ فارم سے مجاجز کو حضور علیہ السلام کے ذکر بابرکت کی اس محفل میں شریک ہونے کا موقع ملا اس کے لیے میں ذاتی طور پر ممنون ہوں ڈاکٹر منصور صاحب کا ادارہ منہاج القرآن ڈیلس کا کہ انہوں نے اس سفر میں سعادت کے سفر میں مجھے بھی شریک رکھا ہے میں اپنے دیے گئے وقت میں کچھ ادائے حمد و نعت آپ کے سامنے پیش کرتا ہوں اللہ رب العزت میرے اس محفل میں آنے کو اور آپ سب کے اس محفل میں آنے کو اپنی بارگاہ میں قبول و منظور فرمائے اور ہماری ہر جائز تمنا کو حضور علیہ السلام کے میلاد کی خوشی میں پورا فرمائے مل کر تو دعا صلی اللہ علیہ کا یا
رسول اللہ وسلم علیک یا حبیب اللہ مل کر صلی اللہ علیک یا رسول اللہ وسلم علیک یا حبیب اللہ. اس حمد سے کلام جو اللہ رب العزت نے مجھے خانہ کعبہ میں عطا کی طواف خانہ کعبہ کے دوران,
اللہ اکبر اللہ اکبر,
یہ حضور کے میلاد کی خوشی ہے جس کی سب سے بڑی برکت کیا ہے کہ ہمیں حضور علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام کے آنے سے اپنے رب کا پتہ چلا کہ ہمارا رب کون ہے. اس سے بڑی فضیلت میلاد کی کوئی نہیں ہو سکتی, باقی اور ہزار ہر. لہذا میلاد کے جلسے میں اللہ کی کبریائی کا ذکر ضرور ہونا چاہیے, یہ ہمارا حق ہے, میلاد کا حق ہے کہ ہم جب اس کی خوشی منائیں تو اپنے رب کی کبریائی کا اور اس کی حمد بیان کریں. لہذا میں چاہتا ہوں کہ مل کر یہ در و دیوار گواہ ہوں کہ اے مولا ہم نے تیری شکر گزاری میں تیری کبریائی کا بیان کیا. مل قبلہ میں پڑھ لوں اس کی
اللہ اکبر
کی خوشنودی اسی میں ہے کہ ہم اپنے رب کا ذکر کریں مل کر
اللہ اکبر اللہ اکبر اللہ اکبر اللہ اکبر کعبے کی رونق تابے کا منظر اللہ اکبر قطرے کو جیسے سمندر سمیٹے مجھ کو مطاف اپنے اندر سمیٹے جیسے
مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کے صدقے ملی. کون سی فضیلت؟ حضرت عمر کا واقعہ بہت مشہور ہے کہ آپ جب اس پتھر کے سامنے پہنچے تو اس سے گویا ہوئے کہ اے پتھر، مجھے تیری حقیقت کا علم ہے، نہ تو نفع دے سکتا ہے نہ تو نقصان دے سکتا ہے، لیکن میں تجھے اس لیے بوسہ دے رہا ہوں کہ میرے آقا کریم علیہ الصلوۃ والتسلیم نے تجھے بوسہ دیا. ساتھ کھڑے حضرت علی کرم اللہ وجہ الکریم فرماتے، عمر تمہیں کیا رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کا فرمان یاد نہیں؟ سرکار علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام نے فرمایا کہ حجر اسود اپنے بوسہ لینے والے زائر کو دیکھتا ہے اور اسے یاد رکھے گا اور حشر کے دن اسے پہچان کے اس کا شفیع بنے گا. صوفیہ کہتے ہیں یہ لمسے لبے مصطفیٰ کا لگ جانا ہے، ورنہ جنت سے آیا ہوا تو ایک پتھر وہاں خانہ کعبہ میں اور بھی رکھا ہے، لیکن شفاعت کی سند صرف لمسے لبے مصطفیٰ کے صدقے حجر اسود کو ملے.
بھیجا ہے جنت سے تجھ کو خدا نے، چوما ہے تجھ کو میرے مصطفیٰ نے، اے سنگِ اسود تیرا مقدر. اللہ اکبر اللہ
شاعر صحیح مکمل کر کے دوبارہ صحن حرم میں آتا ہے اور کھڑے ہو کر خانہ کعبہ کو دیکھتے ہوئے زمزم پیتا ہے اور دعا کرتا ہے. حکم ہے کہ یہ معمولت بناؤ اور دعا کرو, اور صرف حکم نہیں ہے بلکہ دعا کی قبولیت کا یقین دلا گیا. ڈاکٹر صاحب, دعا کی قبولیت کا یقین دلا گیا. اللہ نے اس مرحلے پر جو خیال میرے دامن میں اپنے فضل سے ڈالا, میں نے اسے شعر میں مکمل کیا اور میں آپ کو ہدیہ کرتا ہوں. اللہ یہ سعادت عطا فرمائے, اپنے گھر میں بلائے تو اس مرحلے پر یہ دعا ضرور کیجیے.
اللہ اکبر, اللہ اکبر, محشر
دیکھ کر گفتگو کرنے والا یا کوئی بھی مخاطب ہونے والا اپنا لوازمہ مرتب کرتا ہے ذہن میں, اور مجھے خوشی ہے کہ آپ کے یہاں شعر کی جو ریسیو کرنے کی صلاحیت ہے بہت اچھی ہے. ایسا مجموعہ مل جائے تو پڑھنے والے کا جی خوش ہوتا ہے. اب وہ چاہتا ہے کہ روٹین کی چیزوں سے ہٹ کر کچھ چیزیں ہدیہ کی جائے. چونکہ مکے کا طواف, خانہ کعبہ کا طواف کیا, تھوڑا سا آگے ہٹ کے غار حرا میں بھی چند لمحات. اللہ رب العزت اس مرکز نور میں ہم سب کی حاضری آسان فرمائے.
ہم محل ویلا بھی گئے غار انے
फिर सोए
जाने के बिना फिर सुए हरम काफ़िले जाने के दिन आए काबे में काबे में जबीनों को झुकाने के दिन आए फिर सुए हरम काफ़िले जाने سجاتے ہیں اسی لمحے کی تلاش میں مراقبہ کرتے ہیں کہ اللہ تعالیٰ وہ ایک لمحہ جو جڑنے والا ہے وہ عطا فرما دے ان کیفیات میں جو چیزیں میسر آتی ہیں
اس میں سے کچھ اقتباس آپ کے سامنے پیش کر پاؤں. تقدیر سنور جائے تقدیر سنور جائے سرکار کے قدموں میں تقدیر سنور
ظاہر کی
حسرت ہے خوشبو لگائے پورا وجود اور روح خوشبو میں ڈھل جائے یہ ہے حاضری کے آداب میں جس کو میں اثر آیا
ضائع کی یہ حسرت ہے ڈھل جائے وہ خوشبو
چھڑا تو ایک حاضری کا ایک تاثر پیش کرتا ہوں
جو لمحے تھے
سب سے بڑے معجزے معراج کا بھی ذکر ہوتا ہے اور معراج کا پورا ایک منظرنامہ کہ حضور علیہ السلام کی معراج کیا تھی، کیسے گئے، کیا کیا دیکھا اور ان کی وساطت سے ہمیں کیا کچھ ملا. چند شعر پیش کرتا ہوں.
جمال دنا جمال غری میں دنا دیکھ آئے، جمال غری میں دنا خدا کو حبیب خدا دیکھ آئے، ازل سے ابد تک کے ساتھ
آئے نظام شیر میں دیکھیں شیری منظر نامہ سے خدا تو حبیب خدا دیکھ آئے تجلی سے جس کی قادری کلام وہ جو سب کی سماعتوں سے آشنا ہے، اور اس لیے کہ اس اعتراف کو ہم ان سعید ساعتوں میں مل کر کر لیں تاکہ ہمارے وقت بھی بلند ہو، اور یہ غلامی کا اعتراف اللہ رب العزت ویسے تو آخری سانس کے ساتھ ہمارے ساتھ رکھے، لیکن جب جب ایمان کے اظہار کا موقع آئے حضور صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم سے غلامی کا اظہار والہانہ ہونا چاہیے، یہی ایمان کی نشانی ہے، یہی ایمان کا اظہار ہے۔
لب پر ناتے پاک کا نغمہ
مل کر
کل بھی
آج بھی ہے۔
سے
کل بھی تھا اور آج بھی ہے میرے نبی سے میرا رشتہ کل بھی تھا اور آج بھی ہے
نعرہ تکبیر So as you guys know, our three guests are here, and inshallah there is Dr. Zafar Anjum, Sheikh Haseel Khan Saab, and Imam Zial Haq. And alhamdulillah, the past 3 years, they all have been active here at Jami Hassan al-Basri Minhaj al-Quran Community Center, and all of them have been participating in different tafsir of Qurans, hadiths, Quran classes for the kids on Sundays. There are many other events also starting for the youth, also coming up, and also tafsir of Quran, which they also take part in, also Jummah. So your efforts, all three of you guys' efforts are much appreciated here, alhamdulillah. So now, before I'd like to move on, I would like to pass the mic over to Sheikh Haseel Khan Saab for a brief topic.
Bismillah wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. A'udhu billahi min shaitani rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Sadaqallahu mawlana al-azim. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Mawlana Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Mawlana Muhammad mubarak wa sallim wa salli alayhi. Honestly, it's very challenging to keep this momentum as our respected chief guest, our respected brother Sabir Mani Saab, as the way he was inspiring us. It's very impressive presentation. He traveled all the way from Pakistan. We pray for him, we make dua for him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your efforts and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you in this world, in the life of hereafter. My most honored ulama ikram, my respected elders, contemporary youth, mothers, sisters, innocent beloved children, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Honestly, when I was listening, our respected chief guest, right in the beginning, He started with Allahu Akbar. As I was given for a few minutes, the significance of Miladun Nabi. What's the significance of Miladun Nabi? He presented in the beginning and at the end. Wow. Those who understand Urdu, this is a purpose. This is a significance of Miladun Nabi. That the first thing is, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the ulama ikram, they are sitting here, they can rectify me. The sahaba ikram was sitting, the Rasul salam passed by them and he asked them, he inquired, what were they sitting? Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have gathered here to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ala ni'mat al-Islam. To thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ala ni'mat al-Iman. And why we have gathered here? To thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ala ni'mat al-Muhammad. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala read a great stress. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا Indeed, indeed, I have done a great favor unto the believers that I have sent. We have sent a messenger from among themselves. And we have gathered tonight to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this great blessings, with this great ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a source for all ni'mah. We have received Islam through Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are called ourselves mu'min. We have received iman through Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have received Quran through Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As today we have all other ibadat, that all ibadat and mu'amalat we receive through Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. That is one of the significance of Miladun Nabi. And the second is, we reorient, we reconnect with our minor your universal Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We talk about his external beauty, his internal beauty. Inshallah, soon you will listen, our respected guest, his external beauty. He will reorient, he will reconnect us with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And these are the ma'afil that we increase our iman. We increase our amal. That's a purpose. What are the ingredients? recitation of Quran. Beautiful naat, full of meanings. Jazakallahu khairan, ye pur maghz naat is full of meanings, inspiring us, increasing our level of our iman, is reconnected with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we increase the love of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam in our hearts. And lastly, the message, with the passage of time we forget. The message was brought by Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with the passage of time we forget. And we revise, we remind each other that message. What was that message? The message of peace, message of love, message of brotherhood, sisterhood, equality and justice. That we are forgetting today. The message of peace, we have to think about that the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam has brought us together on one platform. He established the brotherhood. What's going on with us today? Why we are not in peace? Why the Muslims are thirsty for each other's blood? What is it that we have to learn? If something, there's a lagging, there's an animosity and a hatred, with these gatherings, we must remove this hatred and animosity from our hearts and create love in our hearts. And we must practice this equality. We must have this justice. And lastly, that our respected guest, he mentioned the last one. The last one. Look at this. And I'm ending with this one. بتلا دو گستاخ نبی کو غیرت مسلم زندہ ہے. بتلا دو گستاخ نبی کو غیرت مسلم زندہ ہے. مر مٹنے کا جذبہ کل بھی تھا اور آج بھی ہے. Why people are challenging and testing our iman? Why is happening? Why the people, those who do not understand the reality and the status of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they are challenging our iman? Sometimes with the insulting or the cartoons or new fitnas. What's a new fitna? New fitna is, I don't believe the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the final Nabi, final Rasul. Why they don't believe in Khatm al-Nubuwa? This is a challenge for us. And through this mahafils, we enlighten our iman. And it takes us to that level, that mat mitne ka jazba kal bhi tha aur aaj bhi hai. This is the significance of Milad al-Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when we leave this gathering, one of the beautiful, and we always share this beautiful sunnah. Don't forget this sunnah. Because Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam's message is peace, love, brotherhood, equality and justice. And in order to promote love, as a hadith of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the sahabi says, qala ma ra'aytu ahadan akthara tabassuman min Rasulillah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I've never seen anyone more smiling than Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Keep on smiling. Jazakallahu khaira. And now I would like to really invite our next speaker, and he is going to enlighten our iman with the external beauty of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Shamail Mustafa. External beauty. Listen to this. It's really extremely beautiful. And when we hear this, subhanallah, our heart gets connected with the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We love this. And without any further delay, I would like to request our respected Dr. Imam Zia Sheikh. Please.
As-salamu ala Rasulillah. We've had a very beautiful evening in which we've been listening to nasheeds and listening to the beauty of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. One of the things when it comes to expressing love for someone is that we should try to imitate him as much as possible. I'm sure there are many sports fans here and many people that admire sports personalities. When it comes to especially the younger generation, you will find that if they like a particular sports personality, they will go out of their way to purchase a shirt with the name of that personality on the shirt. And they may even go as far as to design their hair in the similar vein or the similar fashion to that sports personality. It's become very common nowadays for people to sport a big beard. And they don't do it based upon the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, rather they do it based upon a particular sports personality that has the beard a certain way. Who's touching the mic? Is somebody adjusting the mic or what's going on? Yeah. Jazakallah khair. So, when we listen to the Prophet ﷺ's seerah and how he looked and how he dressed, the purpose of that is to emulate the Prophet ﷺ in every aspect of his life. And there is a particular book which is called Shamail Tirmidhi, written by Imam Tirmidhi, who's the famous muhaddith, who has this collection of Tirmidhi, but he has a special section in Tirmidhi, which is called Shamail al-Tirmidhi. And in Shamail al-Tirmidhi, he mentions the attributes of the Prophet ﷺ and his habits. And again, we should try to put them into practice and understand them, just so that we understand how the Prophet ﷺ looked, and to emulate him and to follow in his footsteps. So today I'm just going to be talking in particular about the features of the Prophet ﷺ and his beauty. The companions, they used to say in some couplets and some poetry, لَمَّا رَأَيْتُ أَنْوَارَهُ سَتَعَتْ وَضَعْتُ مِنْ خِيفَتِي كَفِّي عَلَى بَصْرِي. When I saw the nur of the Prophet ﷺ shining, I put my hand over my eyes for fear that I might lose my eyesight. خَوْفًا عَلَى بَصْرِي مِنْ حُسْنِ صُورَتِهِ فَلَسْتُ أَنْظُرُهُ إِلَّا عَلَى قَدْرِي. For fear that my eyesight might go because of the beauty of his features, so I could not see him except a certain way. رُوحٌ مِنَ النُّورِ فِي جِسْمٍ مِنَ الْقَمَرِ كَحُلْيَةٍ نُسِجَتْ مِنَ الْأَنْجُمِ الزَّهَرِ. A soul made of light in the form of the moon, as if the brilliant stars were woven into his form. Other companions, they mention similar poetry. لَنَا شَمْسٌ وَلِلْآفَاقِ شَمْسُ وَشَمْسِي خَيْرٌ مِنْ شَمْسِ السَّمَاءِ فَإِنَّ الشَّمْسَ يَطْلَعُ بَعْدَ فَجْرِ وَشَمْسِي طَالِعٌ بَعْدَ الْعِشَاءِ. We have a sun, and the horizons, they also have a sun. And my sun is better than the sun of the sky. Because the sun, it rises after Fajr, but my sun, meaning the Prophet ﷺ, he is apparent even after Isha. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala has said about the beauty of the Prophet ﷺ again in some couplets, وَلَوْ سَمِعُوا فِي مِصْرَ أَوْسَافَ خَدِّهِ لَمَا بَذَلُوا فِي سَوْمِ يُوسُفَ مِنْ نَقَدِي. We know the story of Yusuf ﷺ, how he was sold into slavery, and people purchased him for a very meager price. وَشَرَوْهُ بِثَمَنٍ بَخْسٍ دَرَاهِمَ مَعْدُودًا. It's mentioned in Surah Yusuf. So she says about the Prophet ﷺ that if those people had heard about the beauty of the cheeks of my beloved Muhammad ﷺ, they would not have spent a penny on Yusuf ﷺ. And remember, the beauty of Yusuf was such that it was exemplary. It was something that was unmatched. But comparing the beauty of the Prophet ﷺ, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha made this statement. And she goes on to say, لَوَاحِي زُلَيْخَ لَوْ رَأَيْنَ جَبِينَهُ لَآثَرْنَ بِالْقَطْعِ الْقُلُوبَ عَلَى الْأَيْدِي. And part of the story of Surah Yusuf is that when Yusuf a.s. emerged in front of the ladies and they had been given knives to cut the fruit, instead of cutting the fruit, they kept on cutting their hands and they didn't even notice. But Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she says about the Prophet a.s. that if the friends of Zulaykha had seen the forehead of the Prophet ﷺ, instead of cutting their hands, they would have cut open their hearts. This was the beauty of the Prophet ﷺ. So his physical description and character have been reported by many of his companions, and through them we learned that he was the most handsome man ever. It is impossible to accurately describe the actual beauty and elegance of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the real beauty of the Messenger is only known to Allah and no one else. This was the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He veiled the complete beauty of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the world and from manifesting into this world. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he had both outward and inward beauty. This was the zahir and the batin perfection. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was given of human beauty that which was appropriate for one befitting someone like him. He was the best of humanity, the best of creation, so the best of creation should get the best of beauty. So the beauty that he was given was befitting his position in society. Anyone who met him would say that they'd never seen anyone like him. He was awe-inspiringly handsome. His handsomeness was covered in dignity, majesty, and reverence. When the companions would sit in the presence of the Prophet ﷺ, two feelings conflicting would come into their hearts. On the one hand, they wanted to sit and admire his beauty, and on the other hand, shyness would prevent them from looking directly at him. Amr ibn al-As radiallahu ta'ala, he's a Sahabi, a very prominent Sahabi. He says, مَا كَانَ أَحَدٌ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ وَلَا أَجَلَّ فِي عَيْنِ مِنْ. There was nobody more beloved to me than the Prophet والسلام, and nobody more glorious in my eyes than him. And he says, وَمَا كُنْتُ أُطِيخُ أَنْ أَمْلَى عَيْنِ مِنْهُ إِجْلَالًا مِنْهُ. I could not fully look at him because of the awe that I had of his presence. وَلَوْ سُئِلْتُ أَنْ أَصِفَهُ مَا أَتَقْتُ. And if anyone would ask me to describe him, I could not do so. Why? Because I could not fully look at his face all the time to take in the beauty of the Prophet ﷺ. Dara ibn Azib radiallahu ta'ala, he says, that kana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ahsana an-nasi wajhan wa ahsanahum khalqan. He says that the Prophet ﷺ, he was the most beautiful in his features and the most beautiful in his creation. Jabir ibn Samura radiallahu ta'ala who says, رَأَيْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فِي لَيْلَةٍ إِضْحِيَانٍ meaning مُضِيئًا فَجَعَلْتُ أَنظُرُ إِلَى رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَإِلَى الْقَمَرِ وَعَلَيْهِ حُلَّةٌ حَمْرَاءٌ فَإِذَا هُوَ عِنْدِي أَحْسَنُ مِنَ الْقَمَرِ. Jabir ibn Samura says that I saw the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام in a night which was مُضِيئًا. مُضِيئًا means it was enlightened. Enlightened with what? The full moon. And I started looking at the Prophet ﷺ while he was wearing a red sheet. And I turned to look at the full moon. And I basically rotated my eyes between the full moon and the Prophet ﷺ. And I figured out that the Prophet ﷺ was more beautiful than the full moon. Ka'b ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala, who says, كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ إِذَا سُرَّ إِسْتَنَارَ وَجْهُ حَتَّى كَأَنَّهُ قِطْعَةُ قَمَرْ وَكُنَّا نَعْرِفُ ذَٰلِكَ مِنْهُ. This is a riwayat of Bukhari. Ka'b ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala, who says that when the Prophet ﷺ was happy, his face used to become enlightened, as if his face was a piece of the moon, the full moon. And we could recognize this happiness in his face. Abu Ishaq radiallahu ta'ala, who says, سَأَلَ رَجُلٌ الْبَرَاءِ بْنِ عَازِبٍ. A person asked Bara ibn Azib, a famous Sahabi, أَكَانَ وَجْهُ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ مِثْلَ السَّيْفِ قَالَ لَا بَلْ مِثْلَ الْقَمَرِ. So the people, the tabi'een, were interested in knowing what the Prophet ﷺ looked like. So this tabi, he asked Bara ibn Azib, was the face of the Prophet ﷺ like a sword? Meaning, was it long and thin? So Bara replied, no, it was like the full moon, meaning it was of a roundish nature. I'm going to skip right to the end because it's a long presentation. And what I'm going to present to you is the hadith of Umm Ma'bad. Umm Ma'bad was a Sahabiya who became Muslim later on. But during the time of the migration, the Prophet ﷺ stopped at her tents and benefited from her, and she benefited from his presence. And this hadith is a very famous hadith in which the description of the Prophet ﷺ is mentioned in great detail. So I'm going to just read it. There's the Arabic and then the English. I'm just going to go through the English because of the lack of time. But this will give you a comprehensive view of what the Prophet ﷺ looked like. In this riwayah, the Messenger of Allah ﷺ, Abu Bakr, his servant Amr ibn Fuhayra, and their guide Abdullah ibn Araqid left Mecca with the intention of the Hijrah, passing the tents of an elderly lady called Umm Ma'bad, who was a resolute and gracious lady. So what she used to do, she used to stay outside her tent, and any travelers passing by, she used to give them hospitality. She would sit upright close to the tents and would give food and drink to travelers. So they asked her if they could purchase some meat or dates from her. Okay, so they'd been traveling a while, extremely hungry, and they asked her, can we purchase some meat or dates from you? And she said, you know, usually she used to treat guests in a good way, but she said that she could not find anything because at that time the people were impoverished and they were going through a period of drought. The Messenger of Allah looked towards a sheep next to the tent. There was a sheep next to the tent, and she said, what about this sheep, O Umm Ma'bad? She replied, this sheep is too exhausted to join the other sheep, meaning it's that all the rest of the sheep have gone for grazing, but this sheep is kind of old, tired, and it cannot even walk, and therefore it stays behind, and it's just weak and too famished to do anything. The Prophet ﷺ said, does it milk? She replied, no, impossible. She is too exhausted to even give milk. The Prophet ﷺ asked, will you permit me to milk her? She said, okay, go ahead. I swear by my father and mother, if you think that she has milk, go ahead. The Prophet ﷺ had the sheep brought before him, passed his hand over the udder of the sheep where the milk accumulates, and pronounced the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the sheep parted her legs broadly and the milk started flowing abundantly, and then the sheep, it stood regurgitating. And the sheep, basically, when it's taking the grass, it regurgitates the cud just like cows do. So even though there was no grass, it started regurgitating as if there was grass in its mouth. The Prophet ﷺ asked for a container big enough for the whole family and milked into it a stream until it was covered completely. And he gave this milk to Umm Ma'bad to drink until her thirst was quenched. So she drank from it, and then he gave his companions to drink until their thirst was quenched, and then he, Prophet ﷺ, was the last to drink, and they all quenched their thirst. The Prophet ﷺ then milked the sheep again into the container until it was filled. He left it with Umm Ma'bad, accepted the oath of allegiance from her, meaning she took bayah from him, and left with his companions. After a short while, the husband of Umm Ma'bad, Abu Ma'bad, came, and he saw the sheep. And basically all of the sheep that he had and the goats, they were weak, you know, very famished, they could hardly walk, and the riwayah says there was hardly any marrow in the bones of those goats. So he saw the milk, and he said, where did this milk come from, O Umm Ma'bad? I didn't leave any sheep with you or goats with you to milk, so where did this milk come from? So she said that a blessed man just passed by us in such and such a state. And Abu Ma'bad says, O Umm Ma'bad, describe him to me. So this is the description where she starts. She said that I saw a radiant man with a luminous face, with a beautiful shining face, and handsome disposition, unspoiled by fleshiness, meaning he didn't have too much flesh on him, he wasn't fat, and he was not tainted by small-headedness, meaning his head was not too small to be out of proportion for the rest of his body. It was just the right size in equivalence with his body. He did not have a protruding stomach, meaning his stomach was not sticking out like many people's does, nor did he have a small head. He is handsome and well-proportioned with large black eyes and long eyelashes. SubhanAllah. His beauty was natural. Nowadays women, they have extensions to their eyelashes. Fake eyelashes are put up, right? Prophet ﷺ, he had natural long eyelashes. The riwayah goes on to say, his voice was strong, meaning it was firm, it was sweet, and it was beautiful. His neck was prominent, meaning he had a long neck. His beard was dense, it was thick, and he had long, fine, arched eyebrows. Again, the women, they make their arched eyebrows. The Prophet ﷺ's eyebrows were naturally arched and they looked beautiful. And it looked like his two eyebrows met, meaning that, and according to other riwayat, there was a very fine layer of hair between the two eyebrows. It was not like a complete unibrow, which was thick all the way through, but a very fine layer of hair which connected the two eyebrows. When he was silent, he would be enveloped in an aura of respect. And when he spoke, he was dignified and impressive. He was the most handsome and majestic person when you observe him from a distance, and the finest and most beautiful from close. His speech was pleasant with pauses, meaning when he spoke, he left gaps in his speech. His speech was clear and distinct, neither too little, meaning not too much brevity that a person doesn't understand what was said, nor too long that a person becomes bored with the speech. You know, some people, they just go on and on and on, and the person is looking at his watch and thinking, when is he going to finish? The Prophet ﷺ's speech was neither too long, neither was it too short. It was as his speech is like strung beads shed from their string. So when you have like a necklace or a tasbih, and you basically let the beads fall from one direction to the other, and they fall all in a row, Umm Ma'bad describes the speech of the Prophet ﷺ that it was like these beads falling in a row. It was so beautiful in its organization. It was such an organized speech. He is of medium stature, meaning he is neither too long nor too short. Neither detestable for tallness, meaning some people, they look so tall that they look odd. Nor offensive to the eye for shortness, meaning when you look at him, his height and his body is in complete proportion, and he is neither too tall nor too short. He seemed like a branch that stands out between two other branches. So he was with Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and Abdullah ibn Araythi, the guide. So between them, he stood in prominence. He looked completely different to them because of his splendor, being the most stunning to look at amongst the three. And the most important of them, he had companions surrounding him who, when he spoke, listened attentively to what he said, and when he commanded, they hastened to fulfill his command. They served and gathered around him, well served and attended without him being stern or reproachful to them. So basically, the Prophet ﷺ, when he commanded, it was done in such a way that it was not rigid like people who boss people around. His speech was such that it was done in a polite way and in a nice way, but yet the respect that he commanded was such that the Sahaba rushed to fulfill whatever he was commanding. So with that, the description of Umm Ma'bad finishes. But Abu Ma'bad, upon hearing this pleasant description of the Prophet ﷺ, he said, "I swear by Allah, this is the man of Quraysh we were told about in Mecca." Meaning, the rumors about the Prophet ﷺ had already come to them, and they had heard about him already. And he said, "I swear by Allah, this is that same man of Quraysh that people are talking about. I'm determined to accompany him if I could go that way." And then finally, basically the story goes that Abu Ma'bad and Umm Ma'bad, they actually go to Madinatul Munawwara, they find the Prophet ﷺ, and they take the Shahada and they become Muslims. And the miraculous thing was that the sheep that the Prophet ﷺ touched, it stayed alive for a further 14 years. That one that was about to die, it stayed alive for a further 14 years, and it continued to give milk for the longest time until it died. So again, there's much, much more that we could talk about Umm Ma'bad and her becoming Muslim, but again, for lack of time, I'm going to stop right here. But the summary is basically that we should try to find out the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ, the surah of the Prophet ﷺ, try to find out how he dressed, how he talked, how he walked. And basically this is an expression of love for the Prophet ﷺ to follow in his footsteps. And I'd just like to mention a brief episode from the Sahaba. One Sahabi, once he was riding his camel or horse, and in the middle of the way, for no reason whatsoever, for apparently no reason, he leaned over to one side. The person who was behind him in his horse or camel, he said, "Why did you lean to one side? I don't see any hindrance in the way, any tree or a branch that made you lean over to one way. Why did you do that?" So he said, in the time of the Prophet ﷺ, right here there was a tree. And when the Prophet ﷺ passed by here, there was a branch sticking out. So he ﷺ, he leaned to one side to avoid hitting the branch. So I just wanted to follow his footsteps and do that, even though that tree is not here anymore. This was the level of love that the Sahaba had for the Prophet ﷺ. They wanted to copy each and every one of his steps. And this is what true love entails. Copying the Prophet ﷺ, imitating him in his ibadah, in his akhlaq, in his manners, in his dealings. This is what true Islam and true love is all about. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us tawfiq to understand and practice what has been said and heard. Jazakumullahu khairan.
بلبلے کرتے رہے گل و چمن کی گفتگو اور ہم محمد کے لب و رخسار کی باتیں کریں. جزاک اللہ خیر فار دس بیوٹیفل ایکسٹرنل بیوٹی شیئرنگ ود اس. بیفور آئی ہینڈ اوور مائک ٹو اور نیکسٹ اینڈ فائنل اسپیکر اینڈ فائنل ریمارکس, یو نو ایز آئی نو سگنیفیکنس آف میلاد النبی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, آئی ہیو اے بک ہیئر مولد النبی کمپائلڈ اینڈ ریٹن بائی ڈاکٹر طاہر القادری. Is full of quotations from Quran, from Hadith, from Aqwal Sahaba, from Salaf Salihin. It's very inspiring. This original in Urdu and translation in English. If you would like to know more about Milad Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, please pick up this book and read it. This really is going to be helpful. And now I would like to, without any further delay, without any introduction, to our next and a final speaker for final remarks. Of course, will not be fair to describe the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam within few minutes. How the poet says, "Zindagiyan khatm ho gayi, qalam toot gaye." Zindagiyan khatm ho gayi, qalam toot gaye. Magar aapke ausaf ka ek baap bhi pura na ho saka. Will not be able to make it. It's not fair. But just for the request of Dr. Saab, Dr. Zafar Anjam Saab, to share few words with us, and present himself in this circle and in this chain. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you jazai khair. Dr. Zafar Anjam Saab, please.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulihi ashrafil mursaleen, wa khair khalqihi sayyidina wa nabiyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Bahut mashhoor hain husn-e Yusuf ki baatein, bahut mashhoor hain husn-e Yusuf ki baatein, جنہیں دیکھ کر عورتیں ہاتھ کاٹیں, جنہیں دیکھ کر عورتیں ہاتھ کاٹیں, اور جسے دیکھ کر سر کٹا دیں صحابہ, جسے دیکھ کر سر کٹا دیں صحابہ, وہ روئے پرانوار اپنی جگہ ہے. جسے دیکھ کر سر کٹا دیں صحابہ, وہ روئے پرانوار اپنی جگہ ہے. صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. Let me share with you first about a live miracle, the mu'jiza of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tonight. What is going on tonight in the horizon? When you leave this place, when you go outside, look at the moon. Subhanallah, all the American newspapers, all the national leading newspapers are full of this information that tonight is the full moon night. It's a chautvi raat ka chand. اور یہ اپنے سائز سے کہیں بڑا آج چاند ہے ماشاء اللہ. یوزلی اٹ از کالڈ سپر مون اینڈ اٹ از ناٹ بگر دین 7%, بٹ ٹو نائٹ مون آؤٹ سائڈ از 14% بگر دین دا یوزل سائز دا نارمل سائز آف دا مون. سبحان اللہ. اینڈ آلسو دا شائننگ دا لائٹ اینڈ دا برائٹنس آف مون ٹو نائٹ is 30% more than usual shining and the brightness of the night. The whole weekend, Friday, Saturday and Sunday, these three nights that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing his special miracle and mu'jiza that we all can observe. We have been listening so many stories from the Sahaba Ridwanullahi Ta'ala Majmain and the relationship of our Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam with the moon. You know, when the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he was a baby and he was, just lying in his crib, the baby crib, and he was looking at the moon. So there are authentic narrations, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he was playing with the moon. Subhanallah. He was pointing with his finger, and wherever his finger was pointing, the moon was moving. The same way as the kids, they play with the toys. The toy of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was the moon. Subhanallah. And we also know the mu'jiza of Shaqqul Qamar, when it was demanded by the people of the Makkah, and the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he just pointed with his finger and it was split into two halves. So we know the mu'jiza. So we have this old relationship of the beauty of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and the moon. And mashallah, tonight we are all celebrating the Maulid al-Nabawi al-Sharif ala sahibu salatu wassalam, and you can see some special thing going on with the moon tonight. Subhanallah. And second, as the concluding remark,